You've been waiting for it, and now I'm going to deliver a full build of AMT's International Payhauler 350 dump truck. It's in 1/25th scale, but because this thing is so gigantic, it comes in an enormous box with a buttload of sprues. This thing's got more plastic in it than the entire Kardashian family put together. Over 425 pieces, 14 and a half inches long, stands almost 6 inches high. Let me put this back here. It barely fits on the desk, the box. We'll start getting the sprues out. And this is just insane. Now, this is what you're used to seeing for a regular model vehicle in 1/25th scale, is some stuff like this. Okay, this seems perfectly normal. We've got a lot of detail parts in here. We got some interior parts molded in that nice yellow. It is a good color for the vehicle. I will be painting it, but you could build it in color. It comes molded in three colors. We got, this is just the skid plate. This huge ribbed piece here. These are fenders. Look at that. This thing is awesome. Look at that, air cleaner. Grab handles, mirrors. All right, I'm tossing these trees behind me because there's no room to keep them all in the desk once we show them. These enormous trees are just to build the dump box. All right, wait till you see that thing come out. But these are just ribbed supports, welded in supports for the giant dump box. Look at that. Exquisite. Now, Model Roundup sent this over for a full build. This is out. This is in stock and ready to buy right now. I will link in the description where you can get your own copy. We're going to keep trying to bang stuff around and get all these sprues out here. We've got our cylinders, our hydraulic cylinders on this tree. We've got more supports for that giant dump bed. We got a bumper here. That is just crazy. We got all these little supports and caps for the end of the supports. Over 425 parts in the box. Still can't believe they can sell it for the price they can with the prices of oil these days. We got steering knuckles. Look at the wheels on this thing. Look at the wheels. That's part of our transmission and engine. We got different air tanks, fuel tanks, frames. There's our differentials. Behind my hand there. Radiator, look at the radiator fan on that. Looks like the front axle. More steering knuckles. Shock absorbers are in pieces. You really get to build it up. Now the manual is something else to look at. We're gonna actually open that one up on this show, but here we go with just the suspension. Look at the frame rails on that. Molded open, clean. Look at the detail on those springs. It's got giant leaf springs. We got each half of the enormous engine. Look at the manifolds on that thing. Gigantic. This kid's kind of intimidating, but we're going to get through it, build it up. You're going to see that it's not so bad, I don't think. I mean, I've read through the manual now. It's got a lot of parts, but it's all straightforward. Drive shafts on there. Look at the fan. If you put that on an electric motor, you could cool yourself down with it just by itself. Here's the last large yellow tree. We got radius arms, belts and pulleys. We got the other half of the springs. We got the tanks on there. Building at 50-50. Look at the little air horns. Look how small those air horns look in real life. They're gigantic. All these airlines and hoses. The good thing about these vehicles is they have pretty simple paint schemes. They're built in giant factories, and they don't spend a lot of time on it like a car with everything fancily detailed. Let's get out a black tree, some white styrene. So you really see, you don't really have to paint this kit. We got our cab, we got our air cleaner, we got windshield wipers. We got little access handles, windshield, filters for the air cleaner, the nice roof here. We've got the little cab itself. That's just the operator's area out of that entire vehicle. Huge vehicle. It's all engine and gears and dump bed. Nicely molded. Nothing's warped. We got a black parts tree here for doing your radiator up, doing your dashboard, interior. The doors open on this thing so you can see inside. The grills are molded in black for you with nice detail. Even the brake shoes. You figure that's like half as tall. Look at the size of the seat right there with my finger behind it. Look at my pinky finger behind those brake shoes. That is intense. Enormous radiator, cab parts, cab floor. That is just so cool. To wait for this. There's the dump bed. Here's the front of the chassis with your grill built into it, your lights, your fans. This is where your cab's gonna mount. Is that nuts? Oh, just the parts review on this thing is longer than most reviews on the internet. We got our nice, huge, I mean, you could use this as a shovel. You could give the baby a bath in it. One large piece, you know, you'll be able to build that straight because it's already been injected for you in that nice yellow. All right, I'm going to switch to the other side of the desk because we're not close to done. On this side, we've got 8 huge Goodyear Unisteel tires. They are two-part tires. You can barely tell, but they do come apart for the molding process. Just use some rubber cement, contact cement to hold those together. Excellent tread pattern. You can always put this on the inside of the vehicle. Awesome tread there. You get 8 of those because it's got 4 on each axle. We've got a really cool full-size spec sheet. The 350 50-ton model. A lot of you guys that love knowing everything about your models. Double-sided spec sheet. They don't include this in a lot of kits. That would actually be really cool if they put that in with even car kits and all that. We got a clear parts tree. Right there. The manual on this thing is something else. It's a book. Tells you how to put it all together, but it also includes reference pictures. So you get the exploded views of everything and reference pictures. And that is one heck of a book. See how you put all those braces and rails and everything on the box? So it looks like an intense amount of parts, but really you're building off other sub-assemblies. The last thing in there is our little decal sheet with actual international logos, Payhauler stripes. We got all of our logos. We've got all of our warnings inside the doors and everything. This is a giant kit. Thanks for Model Roundup for sending this over, because I'm going to start to get gluing, and we'll be back to look at all these sub-assemblies in a little bit. All right, well, first things first, let's talk about the manual. Sometimes some of these older style kits can be a real challenge, but this manual is an absolute godsend. Between the pictures and the manual telling you where to go, they've even got parts where you will see where they will outline the parts on the pictures as well. So you can reconfirm where your things should be and how they're gonna go. This has just been so nice. It's made everything super easy. Also, the kit has a bunch of built-in locators. So there's none of the, sometimes on the older kits, you'll see things that say like, you know, put the parts together and there's really nothing there. You put an axle on a spring and it's just two flat pads touching each other and you gotta wonder about alignment and rigidness and is it gonna hold? This kit is completely different. There are giant locating marks, there are pinholes, everything for all the fine parts to the big parts to get you all the way through it. So let's go all the way through it to get to this point here, where there's my hand. To get to this point here is about 9 hours worth of work for me. And I build 2 kits a week, so I'm really used to it. Give yourself a couple days to put this all together before you get it into paint. You know, don't rush it. It'll go together nicely. Just look at the instructions. I recommend looking at those instructions for at least an hour, kind of reading through them before you start building the kit, and you'll be really familiar with it. Now, the wheel and tire package, I've got the tires glued together with rubber cement. And those will hold those beautifully. And you can see this is the actual side that comes out. And you can see that the ring on there can't really be seen. It just looks like a seam on a tire when it got molded. So that looks beautiful the way it is. That will hold. The wheel and tire package pushes in from either side. These are much too stiff to stretch over a wheel, so don't put your wheels together thinking you can shove the tire package over it. You'll have a very hard time doing so. We're going to get some paint, get those wheels weathered up, then we'll push them around the tires, get the tires dusted up. So assemble all eight of those. That goes really quick with some rubber cement or silicone glue. I've got the hood here with its one air cleaner in white all assembled. We've got our windshield wiper. We've got some mirrors and other parts. Those will all go on later. You can see the nice design of that for the airlines that will be dropping through. The hood to the engine, when we do our final assemblies, that all goes together. Now I've cut a bunch of stuff separate so I can get it painted up. This is the lid for the battery box with its cute little handle on it. We've got some other mirrors, we've got some side steps, parts that I know I would break off during the painting process. So I left those on the tree. We'll get those all painted individually. The brake shoes, definitely want to paint and weather those individually. I don't know if you'll be able to see them, but since we might be able to, I think we will be able to from the back. I will get these painted, dry brushed, and at least they will look better than they do as black plastic. Same with the grills. Let's get a coat of black paint on all the black plastic so it's not as plasticky looking, and then we can just insert them. The radiator is all set to go. I attached the radiator support, realized I didn't need it, but it was already glued in, so I quick snapped it off. But we got the large pin locator there, and these will line up just fine. So our radiator is all set with its big louvers on it. That's all ready to go. We'll paint that black. We've got the enormous skid plate. That I definitely want to paint separate and weather it. We got our grab handles, some handles on the side. Those I don't want to attach now. I guarantee I'll break them off. We'll get these painted and scraped up and weathered on their own. The engine piping, it's all molded in one piece. You don't have to glue any of it together, which doesn't give you any big seams, so that's very nice. We got some exhaust working and stuff like that. We'll get this painted up, a little bit of weathering on it to lighten it up, and then we'll be able to glue that together with super glue at the end. And here with the mud flaps on everything, these are separately attached pieces, so I'll get those painted in black, get a little weathering on them. Same as the headlights. I knew I'd break those off the front bumper if I tried to attach those now. We'll attach those at the end after I get the lenses in it and glue it into place. We'll be all set with those. We won't have any problems. Let's get this absolute monstrosity out here. Start going through all the cool stuff inside. We've got our interior. That I'm going to paint up, hand detail. We'll be able to use a silver pencil to detail those gauges. The interior won't need much aside from a little bit of dusting up. It's got individual pedals you can barely see. It's got the seat. It's got the jump seat in the back for a passenger if they got to get them somewhere. And then we've got our interior or our tank holders for the air tanks underneath glued in place. I'm going to get that all painted one color. The cab is all set to go. All you really do with the cab is install your door hinge, your visor, and this lever up here. Otherwise, the cab in one piece is all set to go. The cab door is two pieces. Now, I'll be able to mask this quick and get it painted, but you do have to join it with the interior panel and then the white panel and the yellow panel. We'll be able to get that painted up, cleaned up, have it looking nice. We'll attach the handle to it and the mirrors and all that later. The door will open when we're done, or it's supposed to. We got another air cleaner that mounts to the actual cab of the vehicle. So we've got that set up. We've got the two batteries, the giant 8D batteries. I used to deliver these for a living. They're called 8D batteries, not D8, and they weigh a ton, and we had to load them into these giant vehicles. I used to do that. I used to run a Batteries Plus way back in the 90s, and those things were enormous batteries. You get big strong arms like Arnold when you deliver 8D, install 8D batteries. We got the rams for the box. They are all plastic. They do assemble so that they will operate and glue together. Just don't use too much glue and you won't have them all smushed together. Like that, just as they should. We'll get those painted, weathered, and attach those later. We've got our air tanks here. Now, you do see all these little nipples and tips on there. You could add, you know, plumb your vehicle if you wished. You wouldn't have any problem with it at all. Here we've got our shock absorbers. I wanted to paint and weather those separately and attach those later. They just slide in, so that won't be a problem at all. They're all two-piece shock absorbers. The engine, a Detroit diesel, has more parts than most modern car kits. It is absolutely enormous, looks the part, everything has a locator on it, everything goes together beautifully, there are no wandering. All the fuel rails, the exhaust manifolds, the starter, the line down here, all these different pumps and housings and everything go together lovely. You're not going to have any problems assembling that engine. Just take your time. Use a good quality model glue. Get that all painted up. Weather it a little bit. You're going to have an excellent model. You could even set that aside from the vehicle. But we're going to be able to see it after it's all assembled. Pull the box off the frame. Now look at all over this model, you're going to see before I paint it all these numbers written on with a little black Sharpie. And why do I do that? Well, it's because the parts are so very similar. They're labeled on the tree, but you'll cut off, you know, 10, 15 parts before you start assembling. So I like to label them so I know left from right, and the manual has the right parts, and the part tree, I'll have them labeled, and then I can glue them together and know exactly what I'm doing. So we've got this massive thing. You could serve cocktails in this thing. This thing would hold a six-pack without even trying hard. We've got it all glued together. You can see by the numbers all the individual parts that go into gluing this beauty together. We've got our mounts for our rams. We've got our hinge mount back here. We've got the rock cleaners. These are little rods we'll mount down and drag between the dualies to get the rocks out from between them. We got our point here to line it up with the center of the frame. We've got mud flap locators, ram locators, mud flap mounts. We've got skirts to keep the side of the truck dry, clean when the dirt comes off either side. We've got the giant cab cover protection all glued together. That's a huge slab of plastic. We got the cab, the bottom of the cab, laid over. It's kind of a tricky little thing to get together here. I did leave these here so I can grab it. These will be completely cut free when we're done. You can see we mount the battery box from underneath. We mount the hydraulic tank from underneath. We mount one of the fenders. I have the other fender here. The reason we don't have that fender glued on is because before we're done, we have to get the interior in from underneath, and it's going to be a lot easier that way. You see we got we big pintle hitch in the front. We got our grill guard, everything on there. We got our tank for our air cleaner. We got our steps, which are glued in from the bottom. We'll have grab handles and steps on the other side when we get done. We'll have a hatch over the battery. This remains open for the hydraulic tank. And this is where the cab floor will be. And this is exactly how the cab is going to mount on top. The door will be in the side. So much to look at. This is an enormous assembly, but the heavy truck factories, it all gets painted one color. So we're going to go ahead and do it like that, but I'll just let you soak in all the detail. The fuel tanks on either side, I will recolor those caps whatever I want. They're just black on the parts tree. But if you wanted to build it just as it is in the yellow, you could. I used copious amounts of Bondine liquid glue on all of this. I love that none of it's chromed. There's no reason for it to be chromed. You can see it's got the dual front springs on either side, the single massive rear springs. It's got the shocks that will be mounted in later. We've got air tanks, reserve tanks. We've got filters. We've got the transmission in here. You want to get that transmission in there. The engine will actually slide in inside the frame. These bars will canter in here. And the engine will mount in roughly there. It's not lined up perfectly right now, but that's where that beast is going to be. So that's how that goes together. We've got our front bumper assembly. Once the engine is in, our front bumper assembly will push in. Whoop, we'll push in from either side, like so. That's going to go on there. We've got the mount for the hinges for our box. And you can just see how heavy-duty a beauty like this is built. All the guards and protections and radius rods and drive shafts. It's got fully posable steering. Now, I glued mine into place. But if you want, this tie rod and these hydraulic rams will operate and move it side to side. I've glued mine in. But you can pose those front wheels however you wish. Also, the front wheels, when you assemble them, are designed not to turn. But if you so wish, the manual shows you how to set up the wheels so that they will spin, so that your model can roll off the shelf and smash on the floor if you desire it to do so. So that is it. You can see the cab mounts there and there. Everything locks in. You can see all these beautiful locating areas for everything. And you can see how I numbered the parts on these as well as I was building it, so I knew what I was doing for the axles and the steering rams and everything. So I've got this all together. I've got to get it over to paint, start getting some color on it. It's a huge build. Come on over, we'll start doing some. Even with everything weathered up, the sub-assembly is pretty daunting. You can see all the stuff that's in front of us. We'll go through the work we've done on camera and off. We got the brake shoes weathered and decorated. Those can be pressed in to the axles. Got the headlights glued in. Got the grills dirtied up just a little bit. I mean, they're already black grills, so we're just going to give a little dust shading to them. We've got all the different mud flaps and the under bumper lights glued together. We've got them weathered up a little bit. The mud flaps are black, so we just went with this. Now I'm going to be applying a dust coat as well, and I'll show you how that's done when the video is over. I'll tell you how it's done because it's super easy. The skid plate, I wanted to rust, but I also wanted to leave a lot of bare steel scratched because it's going to be continuously scuffed and scratched, so it's always going to be exposing more bare metal than anything else. We've got the exhaust and the box warmer all set up, rusted out by stippling those rust-colored paints on it like we were showing. We've got part of the mud flaps in the back, the steel assembly areas that slide into the frame, rusted up and chipped up. Those will always have fresh rust. We got the one loose fender ready to go. That is all set. That will be attached once we get the interior inside. The interior, I did some mild dirt effects on the inside, got those gauges all done, got the tanks underneath it. That's ready to push up from underneath. Most of that will be hidden by the fender. We got our radiator and mount and front bumper set up. That's pretty cool looking. Got it rusted up, got the radiator, the fan shroud. Got a little leak in the radiator when they're always topping it off with fluids. Got a little splash underneath. Put a couple big silver strikes. You know how these louvers are always getting bent and pushed down and scraped up, so I wanted to do that to it a little bit behind that big grill. We'll be able to see that effect back there. That looks pretty cool altogether. We've got some of our air tanks rusted up and detailed. We got the giant hood, which sits like this on the vehicle, way in the back like that. We got that rusted up, stained. They're walking across that. They're stacking stuff on that all the time. Got the air cleaner up there. The area towards the back gets the rust rubbed off a lot less than the area towards the front, and it gets a lot less rain on it, so it doesn't get rinsed off all the time. So that went from nice and white to pretty filthy. The engine is all set to be dropped in the chassis with all of its oil stains. We got the manifolds completely rusted out. Whoop. It's pretty durable too. We got the filters looking somewhat newer because those will get checked and changed pretty often. But otherwise, we've got anything that gets real hot, rusted out. We've got everything else with oil running down and dripping on it, making it look cool and still looks a little liquid because that wash is a gloss. Got the valleys there full of oil from the diesel or diesel stains or whatever from being worked on. This thing's got a lot of generations behind it, so that's going to look cool behind that radiator. Half the engine is exposed all the time anyways. The other half is underneath that hood, so we can pop that hood off at any time. The wheel and tire package is outstanding. Stippled some more rust on the edge of the wheels, gave them a little bit of that black wash on the inside. We got the wheel and tire package, made it more dirty on the inside because of course they're not going to get a chance to clean it, nor are they going to get a chance to clean between those tires. But being rubber, you're going to have dirt gather in between the treads and stay there, but for the most part the rubber will be pretty clean. We're going to do a whole dust effect like I said, so a lot of that's going to get covered up. So you have four duals like that all set up. We'll get the giant chassis out here, the frame, the box. First up will be the hood. The cab is just loosely positioned on there so you can see how it goes. We got everything rusted up, chipped. Battery box is a little cleaner because that's going to have a lid over it. The steps, of course, have more metal chipping around them and dirt inside. We've got some serious surface rust from all the chips kicked up working in that giant mine, hauling stuff all the time. We've got fading on the doors. We don't know where this door came from. Came from something else. Used to be all white, then they kind of matched it. It doesn't really match up anymore. So that is all set, chipped, faded. This side is more chipped and rusted than the other side because there's always someone climbing in and out all the time. The huge dump box, pull it off the chassis there. We got it a little silvered up, chipped up, scraped clean. The paint is never completely gone, So you can see it's had a rough life. Underneath, the paint stays darker, but it does get filthy from the dust and grime. And this doesn't, it gets a little dirty when I see it on real dump trucks, but not extremely. It just gets more dusty. So that's how cool that looks, with a bunch of scraping and all that done to it, as loads will be poured straight out the back, rubbing the paint off constantly, rocks being dropped in, all that kind of equipment on there. We get to the massive frame, which has a lot more rust on it, a lot more crust and dirt and grime. Fuel spills from the box heater back here. We got it darkened up. You can see we've got more scrapes on there. Underneath, we've got it scraped up sufficiently. We've got leaks in the differentials and the U-joints and all the steering mechanism and all that. They're working in a dusty environment. The dust and grime is everywhere. So I have to put it all together. I'm going to use super glue for that. I will be doing my decals after I'm done with everything, and then I'll be doing just a little bit of more weathering and dusting over the top of all of that when I'm done. When we come back in a little bit, we'll have that final. The giant behemoth, the International Payhauler 350 from AMT, sent to me by Model Roundup, the cool peeps, Kirk and Jack over there, sending me this kit, want me to build it up for the show, and heck yes, I had an awesome, awesome time. Now this thing is way too heavy for my normal turntable to spin it. It just won't turn it, so we're going to get to look at it in person here. Got the decals on. I hand painted the IH logo on the grill and then dulled it out. How I got the dust effects and how I faded the decals a little bit more and got all that on there, good old tile grout, all right? Just basic old tile grout. Buy whatever you like. It doesn't matter the brand. And some windshield washer. I puff using a brush. I puff it on the model where I think it should be. And then I take the window cleaner from a really far distance and mist it on there. And that sets it. That's exactly the same process that all those guys that charge you $20 for a little tub of pigment. That's what tile is, folks. Pretty much tile grout is pigment. And it goes on lovely. I wipe it off the tires. Because on the sidewalls flexed, I leave it in the treads, and we get that nice dust and stuck on dirt effect on the side of the dump bed, in the dump bed, around the wheels, the fenders and everything, and some dust on the front and all that. We get that nice effect, and it also helps dull down the decals a little bit, like they've been on there a while. So the kit actually, you know, and I will tell you, 3 days is what I spent, 2 days building, a half a day painting, or a day and a half technically building. The other half of the second day was painting the main color coats and doing that pre-fade work on it that you saw. And the third day, the last day today that I'm filming this, was done all in the weathering that you saw in that section. This kit was not difficult. I did screw up one thing. The cylinder on one side does not work correctly anymore. I compressed it, the paint was a little too dry, and it all dried together. The cylinder on the other side works fine, so we can raise the bed. But when we get past this area, we end up yanking out the raise arm on this cylinder, and it doesn't go all the way up. But we can raise it all the way up with this cylinder, and it will hold in place, and it works fine. I went in and rusted the exhaust even more, added some more scratches with some silver, dusted up underneath the frame where it gets dirty and stays dirty. What an amazing kit. I love the spec sheet AMT throws inside there. Both sides gives you all these cool specs and dimensions of the real vehicle, and this manual is one of the finest I've seen. Just wonderful. Even though it's an older Ertl kit, they did an absolute beautiful job with it, no issues at all. So this was a ton of fun. Now the hood will come off, since it's not spinning around on a turntable. Get that carefully. We'll pull that hood off. You can see that Detroit diesel underneath there. We got our black air lines, our radiator lines. We've got our rusted out exhaust down to the box heater, which lines up right across there. Ton of fun. Is this a first model kit for someone? Not a chance. Is it a second model kit? Doubtful. But If you can assemble a more complex glue together kit, you're not going to have a lot of problems with it. It's just big and has a lot of parts. But this manual and the way those parts are designed, with holes pre-cast in for handles, locator marks on the axles, everything is, you don't have to drill anything through, you don't have to beat anything up. You can assemble this kit. You can do it. You can paint it. It just needs two colors for real. You know, it just really needs white and yellow. The black stuff comes in black, so you really don't even need to paint that. And if you just wanted to build it as it is and do it that way, you'd be fine. But if you want to go the extra mile like I do on this one and weather it up, because they don't make these trucks anymore, you're not going to have any issue doing that either. I really enjoyed the build. I'm so glad for our sponsor, Model Roundup, to send me this kit. They've got it in stock. I will link down in the description, as always, where you can get yours. Build your Payhauler for you. Build it new. Build it super used up. Build it just a little bit dirty from its first day at work. Do whatever you want, as long as you enjoy yourself. Thanks for watching the workshop. I'll have pics at the end. We'll see you at the next review.